Nystagmus. Nystagmus is an involuntary rhythmic shaking or wobbling of the eyes. Nystagmus has also been described as dancing eyes or jerking eyes. Nystagmus may be unilateral or bilateral. Nystagmus may be conjugate or disconjugate, dissociated. It may be horizontal, vertical, torsional, or any combination of these movements superimposed on each other. Nystagmus may be congenital or acquired. Physiology of maintaining eye position. To understand the mechanisms by which nystagmus may occur, it is important to discuss the means by which the nervous system maintains the position of the eyes. Foveal centration of an object of regard is necessary to obtain the highest level of visual acuity. Three mechanisms are involved in maintaining foveal centration of an object of interest. Fixation, the vestibular ocular reflex, and the neural integrator. Fixation. Fixation in the primary position involves the visual system's ability to detect drift of a foveating image and signal an appropriate corrective eye movement to refoveate the image of regard. The vestibular system is intimately and complexly involved with the oculomotor system. One of the reflexes connected with balance is not learned. It is present at birth. That is, the automatic control of eye movements during head turns, known as the vestibular ocular reflex. In health, if you turn your head, your vision does not normally turn into a blur. You will focus very briefly on one view, then another, till you have completed the head turn. The vestibular ocular reflex is a complex system of neural interconnections that maintains foveation of an object during changes in head position. The proprioceptors of the vestibular system are the semicircular canals of the inner ear. Three semicircular canals are present on each side: anterior, posterior, and horizontal. The semicircular canals respond to changes in angular acceleration due to head rotation. Third mechanism is the neural integrator. When the eye is turned in an extreme position in the orbit, the fascia and ligaments that suspend the eye exert an elastic force to return towards the primary position. To overcome this force, a tonic contraction of the extraocular muscles is required. A gaze-holding network called the neural integrator generates the signal. The cerebellum, ascending vestibular pathways, and oculomotor nuclei are important components of the neural integrator. Pathophysiology of nystagmus. A disorder affecting any of the three mechanisms that control eye movement may result in nystagmus. Both focal and diffuse disorders may cause nystagmus. The characteristics of the nystagmus, as well as associated signs and symptoms, help to localize the lesion and suggest possible etiologies. Vestibular nystagmus may be central or peripheral. Important differentiating features between central and peripheral nystagmus include the following. Peripheral nystagmus is unidirectional with a fast phase opposite the lesion. Central nystagmus may be unidirectional or bidirectional purely vertical or torsional nystagmus suggests a central location. Central vestibular nystagmus is not dampened or inhibited by visual fixation. Tinnitus or deafness is often present in peripheral vestibular nystagmus, but is usually absent in central vestibular nystagmus. Downbeat nystagmus is defined as nystagmus with the fast phase beating in a downward direction. The nystagmus usually is of maximal intensity when the eyes are deviated temporarily and slightly inferiorly. With the eyes in this position, the nystagmus is directed obliquely downward. The presence of downbeat nystagmus is highly suggestive of disorders of the craniocervical junction. For example, Arnold-Chiari malformation. Upbeat nystagmus is defined as nystagmus with the fast phase beating in an upward direction. This type is suggestive of lesions of the medulla. Torsional nystagmus refers to a rotary movement of the globe about its antero-posterior axis. Torsional nystagmus is accentuated on lateral gaze. Most nystagmus resulting from dysfunction of the vestibular system has a torsional component superimposed on a horizontal or vertical nystagmus. This condition occurs with lesions of the anterior and posterior semicircular canals on the same side, that is, lateral medullary syndrome. Pendular nystagmus is a multivectorial nystagmus, that is, horizontal, vertical, circular, elliptical, with an equal velocity in each direction that may reflect brainstem or cerebellar dysfunction. Horizontal nystagmus is a well-recognized finding in patients with a unilateral disease of the cerebral hemispheres, especially with large posterior lesions. It is often of low amplitude. Seesaw nystagmus is a pendular oscillation that consists of elevation and intorsion of one eye and depression and extorsion of the fellow eye that alternates every half cycle. This striking and unusual form of nystagmus may be seen in patients with chiasmal lesions, suggesting loss of the crossed visual inputs from the decussating fibers of the optic nerve at the level of the chiasm as the cause, or lesions in the rostral midbrain. Gaze-evoked nystagmus is produced by the attempted maintenance of an extreme eye position. It is the most common form of nystagmus. Gaze-evoked nystagmus is due to a deficient eye position signal in the neural integrator network. Thus, the eyes cannot be maintained at an eccentric orbital position and are pulled back towards primary position by the elastic forces of the orbital fascia. Then, corrective saccade moves the eyes back towards the eccentric position in the orbit. Spasmus Newton's is a rare condition with the clinical triad of nystagmus, head nodding, and torticollis. The onset is from age 3 to 15 months, with disappearance by 3 or 4 years. Rarely, it may be present up to the age of 5 to 6 years. The nystagmus typically consists of small amplitude, high frequency oscillations, and is usually bilateral, but it can be monocular, asymmetric, and variable in different positions of gaze. A thorough history is important to help determine the etiology of the nystagmus. Important aspects of the history include the following: age of onset of the nystagmus, whether it is constant or intermittent, the presence of any aggravating or alleviating factors, for example, head position, presence or absence of vertigo, and sensation of disequilibration suggest a lesion of the vestibular system. Deafness or tinnitus is present with peripheral lesions of the vestibular system. Presence of diplopia, particularly in certain positions of gaze. Causes of seesaw nystagmus can be rostral midbrain lesions, paraceller lesions, for example, pituitary tumors, visual loss secondary to retinitis pigmentosa. Causes of downbeat nystagmus can be lesions of the vestibular cerebellum and underlying medulla, including the following: Arnold Chiari malformation, demyelination, for example, multiple sclerosis, microvascular disease with vertebrobasilar insufficiency, brainstem encephalitis, tumors at the foramen magnum, for example, meningioma, cerebellohemangioma, trauma, drugs, for example, alcohol, lithium, anti-seizure medications, nutritional, for example, Wernicke's encephalopathy, parenteral feeding, magnesium deficiency, heat stroke. Approximately 50% of downbeat nystagmus have no identifiable cause. Causes of upbeat nystagmus can be medullary lesions, including perihypoglossal nuclei, the adjacent medial vestibular nucleus, and the nucleus intercalatus, structures important in gaze holding. Lesions of the anterior vermis of the cerebellum. Benign paroxysmal positional vertigo. Causes of periodic alternating nystagmus can be Arnold Chiari malformation, demyelinating disease, spinocerebellar degeneration, lesions of the vestibular nuclei, head trauma, encephalitis, syphilis, posterior fossa tumors. Causes of pendular nystagmus can be demyelinating disease, brainstem or cerebellar dysfunction. Causes of spasmus Newton's can be usually occurs in otherwise healthy children. Chiasmal, suprachiasmal, or third ventricle gliomas may cause a condition that mimics spasmus Newton's. Lateral medullary syndrome. Causes of abducting nystagmus of intranuclear ophthalmoplegia can be demyelinating disease, brainstem stroke. Causes of gaze-evoked nystagmus can be drugs, anticonvulsants at therapeutic doses, alcohol, any medication that may be causing the nystagmus should be discontinued in conjunction with the patient's physician. Significant refractive errors should be corrected.